How's it going, guys? James Weiss here. Real quick, before the actual video for the reaction starts, I just want to make this video real quick saying that the reaction that you're about to see, I actually filmed a couple days ago when the video for Shin Lim first was posted like an hour ago. But unfortunately, I was having technical difficulties with my computer, and I literally could not edit whatsoever. I couldn't even open up the program. I have fixed it, so that's why you're seeing this. So, just want to let you guys know that the video was actually filmed a couple days ago when this was first uploaded. So, check it out. Hope you love the reaction. What's going on, guys? James Wise here, and we are back with another reaction video. We are going to be reacting to Shin Lim on America's Got Talent. Real quick, I just want to explain this so people understand, so we're all on the same page. Real quick. This is, as the title suggests, this is a magician reacts video, not a magician reveals video. I am a magician, and I am simply reacting to this performance. I will not be explaining how the trick is done, because that's not what this is. So if that's what you're here for, sorry, you're in the wrong place, and sorry. I know there are plenty of people who say that somehow these videos are misleading, or there's even some people that say that even put their own definition to what magician reacts means. I just want to clarify that for people. I'm a magician, and I'm reacting. That's it, guys. Just want to let you know. So that way we're all on the same page. All right. So, like I said, this is Shin Lim on America's Got Talent. I have reacted to Shin Lim in the past before. If you have not seen him before, you are missing out, because Shin Lim was on Penn and Teller Fool Us, the TV show, twice, actually. And he fooled Penn and Teller both times. And some of the best magic performances I've ever seen. It's just so beautiful the way he synchronizes his moves to the effects, to the music, to just the drama into it. It's beautiful. So I am really interested to see what Shin Lim is going to do in this performance, because he also does YouTube videos, and I watch those a lot. And in those videos, he does say that he's not going to be doing the Dream Act or the 52 Shades of Red routine that he has done on Penn & Teller Fool Us just yet. He said this is going to be a brand new routine. That way he's not doing his best at the very beginning, because that I kind of agree with him on that, is that whenever magicians go on these Got Talent shows, they do their best illusions and their best tricks right up front. That way people get engaged and they continue to the next round. But because that was their best, their second or third performances suffer and they're not very good. So Shin is being smart. It is a risky play, simply because if you bring your best, people respond better and you have a better chance of going forward. But it makes complete sense. So without further delay, let us take a look at Shin Lim on America's Got Talent. I'm super excited about this. Let's go! Tower Banks.
Just pick one.
Anyone.
He's actually talking. Wow.
Oh, you can see it. Yeah. Oh, okay.
Can you write your name?
Okay.
No. Damn, that was good. That was clean.
Thank you.
Damn, okay, that was good. This guy's awesome. Oh man, he changed the whole deck. Oh, that's so tight. It's so good. I love how he just moves with the music as well. I love everything he does. Oh, nice. He's doing that trick from Justin Flom. Side of his envelope, I wonder. What? Okay. That genuinely fooled me. Okay, I have no idea how he did that. Oh, that's nice. I really like that, the visual part of that. That's so cool. And the smoke. Shin Lim always does the smoke. He's so good at that crap. And it's together?
Oh my god! And my name is inside of like glass or something. It's like sealed inside. No?
Okay, Shin, just chill. Just chill. Okay, just Shin, just chill for a second, okay? okay, yeah, that was, of course, like usual, Shin Lim blew me away. There, of course, definitely were some moments in there where he kind of messed up a little bit, especially one part in particular. But, I mean, who that stuff doesn't matter because the rest of the routine made up for it. And yeah, that was good. That was definitely a unique performance, a new performance that he's done that I've never seen him do. Things like turning the cards completely like clear cards, and then he made the cards into like one solid piece of glass, which is the Omni deck kind of thing. But how he used that in correlation with the rest of the routine, I don't know. And then of course when he puts the glass deck in the box, smashes it in her hand, rips it up, the box apart, and it's gone. That was good. That genuinely fooled me, and just blew it out of the water. this isn't really a competition anymore now that Shin Lim is here, because if he doesn't win, it's gonna be complete BS. So. But, oh god, that was so good. If you got, no, I'm being totally serious, guys. If you have not seen Shin Lim's work, after this video, YouTube search Shin Lim, Penn and Teller Fool Us. Watch both of his performances. He does two tricks, or two performances called The Dream Act and 52 Shades of Red. Both are so fantastically beautiful. If you're gonna watch the 52 Shades of Red performance, though, I do recommend watching the performance he did in Beijing, China. I believe that one is actually a little bit of a better performance than the one he did on Fool Us. Just because there were a few moments, a few beats, and just a few other extra effects in there that I feel as though, even though some of the moves might not have been as clean, I feel as though those beats, as well as the music, is exactly what that routine needs. And I guess he just wasn't able to use the right music for the Fool Us show for copyright reasons, I'm guessing. So, but either way, check those out because it's fantastic. As far as this performance, this is absolutely fantastic. Hey, you did, Shim, you're probably not watching this, but if you are, great job, man. Keep up with the great work. I've actually been pretty much a huge fan of yours since you first started releasing effects on Theory 11 on the Wire. So, yeah, keep it up, bro. I can't wait to see what you do next. I'm guessing the next ones we'll start seeing is like 52 Shades and The Dream Act. So, keep it up, bro. And, yeah. So, hey, I hope you enjoyed this this reaction, guys. Like I said, it is nothing. It's just a reaction. Nothing more. Leave comments down below. Comment below. What did you guys think of this performance? Please refrain from trying to reveal it. I'm probably going to delete those comments because, I mean, come on, guys. Let's respect the art. Let's just enjoy it for what it is as an art form, and less of just like this puzzle you have to figure out, exposing the trick. Just sit back, relax, enjoy the show. But comment down below what you thought of this. And, man, it's crazy. Anyway, like this video. Subscribe to my channel. I do much more than just reactions. I have actually a lot of magic videos as well. Speaking of which, I've been getting a lot of messages asking me when, you know, James, when is it going to be more magic, more magic? Don't worry, I have some awesome magic coming along very, very soon. Just putting up some final touches on some stuff. And I'll upload it as soon as possible. So that way you're not... I realized lately it's been pretty much just reactions for the last like 15 videos. So, I digress though. But anyways, check out my other videos. My last video was performing magic for Jessica Negri. I actually, for the second time, so check out both those performances. Hit that subscribe button, hit that bell, that notification button. That way, if I upload videos, you'll get notified immediately and you can watch it as soon as possible. Hit that like button, comment down below. Also, in the description down below will be my social media, my Twitter, Instagram, and Facebook. Follow me there and check out my other videos. So until then, I will see you guys next time.